वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल?
फाइन मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम. फाइन मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग. गुड मॉर्निंग. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेरी सेफ एंड हेल्दी. दैट्स मोर इम्पोर्टेंट टू यू नो डू एनी न्यू बिगिनिंग. आई होप यू एंड योर फैमिली आर ऑल गुड एंड सेफ हेल्दी एट होम, राइट? Anyway, let's begin our second semester. I think last week we have been given instructions to begin off our second semester right from 10th. Of course, since you all had placement training and all that, we are starting today. And for all your information, I'll be teaching database management system along with the lab. That's a subject that I'll be handling for all of you. I hope all of you would have studied DBMS in your graduation. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Yes, so, ma'am. Yes, my job is easy then. It's not like DMS, correct? Okay. So somehow, somewhere, you would have touched upon a little, at least. Learning about DBMS, some queries you would have already executed anyway. So I don't know how much of that you all remember, and it is going to help you now in this second semester. Well, I'm not sure about it, but anyway, we'll do our best, and I expect the same from you all. Before I begin, there was some software and installation guidelines was shared to you yesterday. So were all of you able to install the software, or what is your status?
Yeah, I'm installed.
Installed. Okay. Let me check each of you before we begin. Abhilash, what is the status at your end? Abhilash, Akrut, have you done it?
No, ma'am. It is.
I'm not able to hear you. Tell me again, Akrut. Anaga.
Oh, I will install today, ma'am.
You'll install today. Okay, fine. Yes, Akrut, tell me. Akrut? Okay, I don't know what's happening. All right, okay, Akrut. Anusha?
Ma'am, I'll install it today, ma'am.
You'll do it today, okay. Arvind?
I've installed it, ma'am.
Done, no issues?
No issues, ma'am.
Okay, good. ಅರಿಫುಲ್ಲ
ಇನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ.
ಇವತ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ?
ಹಾ, ಓಕೆ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಮಾಡಿ ಮುಗಿಸಿ. ಭಾರ್ಗವ್?
ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಾಲ್ ಟುಡೇ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಆಲ್ ರೈಟ್. ಚೈತ್ರ?
ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಾಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ನೋ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್?
ನೋ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಓಕೆ, ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್. ಚಂದನಾ? ಎಸ್, ಶಿ ಸೆಡ್ ಶಿಲ್ ಡು ಇಟ್. ಯು ಡನ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಚಂದನಾ? ಸಾರಿ.
Yes, ma'am, it is an on process, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. Darshan?
I have it, ma'am. Installed.
Okay, good. Dakshayani, you told you'll do it today. Yeah, I got it. Divya?
Ma'am, I'll do it today, ma'am.
All right. Hemalata?
I'll do it today, ma'am.
All right. Huma?
Ma'am, I'll do it today, ma'am.
Okay. Jayant?
I'll do it today, ma'am.
Sure. Kaushik?
I will do it today, ma'am.
Okay. Lakshmi? All right. Okay. Lavanya?
I'll do it today, ma'am.
All right. Manish?
I'm installed.
Good. Manoj?
I will do it today, ma'am.
Yeah. Mohit?
Installed, ma'am.
Very good. Any issues?
No, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Navel?
I will do it today, ma'am.
Yeah. Navya?
I'll install it today, ma'am.
Okay. Nikhil?
I'll do it today, ma'am.
Sure. Panindra?
I'll do it today, ma'am.
Pooja?
I'll install it today, ma'am.
Okay. Rahmatullah? Raman?
I'll do it today, ma'am.
Okay. Rashmi?
I'll do it today, ma'am.
Rupak?
Yes, ma'am. I've installed it.
No issues?
No, ma'am.
Very good. Sai Kumar?
I will do it today, ma'am.
Samir?
I'll install today, ma'am.
Okay. Shadab?
I'll install it today, ma'am.
Sharon?
I'll install today, ma'am.
Shashank?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you should tell me. Okay, you joined late, looks like that. I was asking whether you have received the installation guidelines on the software and have you done the installation? Shashank? Sheetal?
I'll install it today, ma'am.
Yeah. Shivani?
Ma'am, I'll do it today, ma'am.
Yeah. Soumya?
Installing, ma'am.
You're installing. Okay, fine. Spurti?
I will do it today, ma'am.
Okay. Vishnu?
Yeah, ma'am. Done, ma'am.
Yeah, done. Good. No issues, no?
No, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Sugandhini?
Yes, ma'am. Installed.
Installed. Very good. Sushma?
I will do it today, ma'am.
Sure. Sushmita?
I'll install today, ma'am.
Okay. Sushmita, you?
I'll do it today, ma'am.
Sure. Tirtha?
I'll do it today, ma'am.
Tripti?
Ma'am, I'll install today.
Okay. Varsha?
I will do it today, ma'am.
Veena?
I will do it today, ma'am.
Right. Good. So some of you have, I think very few of you, I should say, have installed. The others, I think, will complete it today. That's really nice of you all. And so that, you know, we'll have the software and you can also start trying the lab exercise as and when we go forward. All right. Yeah. Now, before I begin with exactly going into the lab syllabus, I want to actually give you all what we will be learning as part of DBMS theory as well as lab before, you know, we get into the details of our lab experiments. Let me quickly see if I can share my screen. Yeah. This is lab syllabus. You're able to see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. All right. So what I would want to show here is particularly the syllabus. Let me go quickly into the syllabus. Yes. So this will be the syllabus that we'll be covering for DBMS theory. So let me start. So we'll be learning the first module, basically an introduction about DBMS, what are the different characteristics of the DBA database approach, what is the activity of the database admin? What are the advantages of using DBMS? And then we'll also learn about what is a schema, what is an instance, a three schema architecture, what exactly is data independence, and then the difference between centralized and client-server architecture, classification of DBMS. So this is what we'll be learning in case of the first module. Moving on to the second module, we'll be learning about relational database. Relational database is different, SQL is different. You should understand the difference. So as we go ahead, I'll be letting you know what is exactly the difference between SQL and relational database, and how we can query using SQL, and how can we write a query using relational database. All that we'll be learning. We'll be learning ER model, how to write an entity diagram or an entity relationship diagram. What is an entity? What is an attribute? What are the different types of attributes? So given any database or any application, you should be able to write a ER diagram. That's very important. We'll also be learning about different normal forms, first normal form, second normal form, BCNF, these things also we'll be learning. And what was I sharing? So that will be your second module. Third module, we'll move on to SQL in detail, certain, syntax of certain several commands. What are the different functions? How do we update? How do we delete? What are the aggregate functions? Group by clause, having clause, all this. You would have touched upon definitely in your graduation. We'll be getting into the details of all that now. Fourth module starts with triggers, views. These are all very important things, stored procedures, functions. These are all there. Then module 5, you'll be dealing with the transaction processing and recovery team. Okay, so these are the different 5 modules that we'll be learning in database or DBMS. Now, before I go into further details, I also want to tell you what are the course outcomes of this particular course. You're able to see as I move along the document?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, very good. If there is any issue, please stop me, tell me, okay? Otherwise, I am under the impression that things are reaching you. So course outcomes, even when we started off with the discrete mathematics, the first, very, very first class, if all of you remember, I was talking of course outcomes of that particular subject. Yes. So course outcomes means what? At the end of that subject, means at the end of this semester, you would have finished learning DBMS. So what would we expect from the student? Or what is the student, what is it the student will be able to do? So the student will be able to apply the basic concepts of database management. That is one of the important course outcome. Then the student will be able to design ER diagrams to solve simple database application. This is what I told, that given any application, you should be able to design a ER diagram so that you get an idea of what exactly that database is all about. What are the entities that are involved? What is the relationship between the different entities? What are the different attributes that are involved? These things you will get to know. You should be able, third outcome is you should be able to formulate SQL queries in Oracle. So since we'll be using Oracle, we'll be learning how to write simple queries, how to write some complex queries. So you should be able to formulate SQL queries whenever any particular application is given to you. Then improve the database design by normalization. So as I told you already, that we'll be learning and touching upon the different normal forms. We have first normal form, second normal form, the third normal form, Boyce-Codd normal form, that is BCNF. So all this fourth and fifth normal form is also there, but I don't think it is necessary in your syllabus. I think we'll be touching upon 3 normal forms and the BCNF. Okay. So you should be able to improve the database design by normalization. That is again another course outcome. And then the last one is build database for any given problem. That's a final one wherein it is a culmination of all these things. Whatever you are learning based on using all that knowledge, you should be able to build a database for any given problem. So given any problem, let us say a simple problem I will take is a student management system or a library management system. So we have COVID management, let us say. So you should be able to build that. That becomes a very simple database. But of course, you can have very simple database. You can have a very complex database also. So how are you going to go about designing these databases? At the end of this course, you should be in that kind of a position. Right. So that is what we'll be learning in terms of DBMS as a theory. Any queries so far? All right. So now quickly let me share. The lab syllabus. I'll be sharing a copy of the syllabus to you all. Do you all have an access to the syllabus already?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is the first exercise we will be learning or dealing with the five important, five exercises as given in your syllabus. The first one is something like this, where you are supposed to create a database or a student database rather, with all these details, branch, student, whatever. And then they have also given what are the queries that you will have to answer. We have around 8 queries that they have listed. We can also have some extra queries that we will be doing for every exercise, because in the examination, Viva need not be exactly in the form of a Viva. They can ask you to write a different query apart from what is there in the syllabus, and they may consider that as a Viva also. That is also possible, because Viva at the end of the day is what, just to test you how much you know in that subject, correct? How much you know about that subject, whether you are by hearting or really you have some stuff, that is what they want to test. So Viva OC need not always be, in this case, in this subject, need not be always a kind of a question answer. If a particular application has been asked to you to, you know, build a database and answer some queries, of course, what is there in the syllabus, you will have to bring out the results. But the questions can also, Viva questions can also be in terms of queries. That's what I'm saying. Suppose your first exercise is given to you in the examination. Apart from these 8 queries, they may give you some other query to get the result. So if you are able to answer, write that query on your own and get the result, and then that will fetch you marks. Okay, so that's the first exercise. First and second are pretty simple. As far as your syllabus of lab syllabus is concerned, I think we should be able to do without much of difficulty. Third one is again based on some cricket tournament and database. Fourth exercise, it's again based on some tourism. Fifth exercise is something on election. Okay, how the number of voters, and this is basically we have here a trigger concept is involved and a stored procedure is also involved. The little complex is your fifth exercise. So these are the five exercises that we'll be doing it in the lab. So it is better that you get your software installed as early as possible, so that as and when we start doing it, you can also try it along with me, or at least after the class or the lab is over, you can do it on your own. It should not be a problem for you. Okay. Right. Next. You are able to see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Now, before we go into exactly the lab syllabus, I want to actually give you all some kind of an overview of what SQL is, what are some of the basic commands, how we can what is the syntax of some of the important basic command, what are the different types of commands. These kind of brief general introduction I want to give, an overview I want to give about SQL, because we'll be using SQL before we go into the lab exercise. So first lab exercise I will not be doing today. Today I'll only be touching upon the different commands that are there in SQL and things like that. Okay. So let us start with one second. So we'll be basically using Oracle 10G. I think that is what is shared with you all. I tried installing 11G. There are several versions. 12G is also there. But 11G is showing some problem. I am not able to install it. So I thought the same issue may be there at your end also. So that's why we decided to go for Oracle 10G. Okay. So this is what we'll be, this is more important for you to know which version of Oracle you are working on. All right. So that's the reason I'm telling that. Now we will be learning what is SQL. What is SQL?
Query language.
Structured query language.
Yes. Structured query language. Anything other than that? Okay, that's an expansion of structured query language. What is structured query language? Should I put it like that? Yes, anyone? Yeah, come on. You all have learned it in your graduation. It's not new subject for you, like unlike DMS, is it not? DMS, all of you said we have not learned. Many of you all told that. But DBMS, I will not agree also, even if you say. Because your graduation is not complete without DBMS, is it not? What is SQL? Tell me. I want the class to be interactive. Don't simply sit like this.
A relational database.
Data is stored in the form of rows and columns.
Okay. Now you are trying to answer
manipulation of records we can do with
use it for database creation.
It's used for database creation. One by one, please.
It is used to interact with database.
Okay.
It is domain specific.
It is domain specific. Okay, any other answer?
Used for manipulation of data.
Manipulation of data, all right. Any other answer, Vishnu?
No, ma'am.
Okay, Sushmita, you.
The data is stored in the form of rows and columns.
Okay. Now that data is stored in the form of rows and columns is you are talking of database. So we are not talking of database here. Okay. I haven't gone into that at all. What I'm asking you is what is an SQL? All right. SQL is a, anyway, I'll come to this answer. SQL is a, as you all told, it is a structured query language. Now this SQL, it is actually provides an interface. Provides an interface means you already have the database. Okay. Now you want some kind of a communication link between the database and the user. Oracle, let us say, is a database that we are using. So we have already created our table and our data, as your friend told, data is stored there in the form of rows and columns. It is already stored. But how do I access that particular data? That I need some way of some kind of an communication path in order to access that particular data. So that way SQL plays an important role, or rather it provides us an interface to the relational database or whatever database we have. It provides an interface. One such interface is your SQL or the structured query language. It's a language, you know. So you are going to write some queries so that you can able to, you will be able to access the or retrieve the data from the database. Database is different, SQL is different. When I ask SQL, we cannot say, okay, data is stored in the form of rows and columns. Data is stored in the form of rows and columns is a database. That is different. Database is already there. How do I make use of that database? How do I retrieve the data from the database? How do I put the data into the database? How do I modify the data? How do I insert some data? How do I access that data? How do I delete that data? How do I do that? That is all with the help of this SQL. So this SQL, it actually provides an interface to the database that we already have. Now SQL basically was developed by IBM. Okay, it was developed by IBM in 1970s around. It was developed by Now let us move to the very important concept. What are the components of SQL? Now, when I say components, when we talk of SQL, there are different types of commands. What are the different types of commands that we have is what we are going to learn. All this classification of commands, the different types of commands, all these things you should learn or you should know before we jump into any kind of practically when we start doing or working with SQL. Before we work with SQL, I want to give you this kind of an introduction. That is why I'm doing this. After we do this, we'll move on to SQL. Okay. Right. Now, in case I said, what are the different types of commands that we have? Now, there are, four different types of commands. One is called as the DDL commands. Then we have something called the DML commands. Then we have the DCL commands. And then we have DQL commands. These are the four different types of commands. It is very important for you to understand what are each of these types of commands. Okay, what do we mean by DDL? What do we mean by DML, DCL, DQL? What do we mean by these commands? And what are the commands that come under each of these? That's a very important understanding that you should have before we jump into the SQL and start working on that. Now, when I say DDL, DDL stands for?
Data Definition Language.
Very good. DDL stands for Data Definition Language. DML stands for?
Manipulation.
Manipulation.
Data Manipulation Language.
Data Manipulation Language. What about DCL? What does it stand for?
Control
language. What is DQL?
Data query language.
Right. These are all the expansion of what we have written down is all fine. Okay. What you should know is what are each of these. Okay. Now, when we come to DDL, anybody? What is a DDL command?
Table creation.
Table creation, that's all? Dropping a table is DDL. Okay. Okay, go ahead. Let me see what are the answers we get. The dropping a table, yes, Arvind?
Altering the table.
Altering the table. All right, okay.
Mm-hmm. Ma'am?
Yeah.
It is used to define the type of data that is to be stored.
Define the type of the data to be stored. Okay. Mm. Then? Kaushik?
To define two entities.
Define two entities. Okay. All right. So I'm getting different answers used to define the database schema. Soumya, okay. All right. So now let's come to the answer. Now, whenever I say DDL or data definition language, it is a set of SQL commands. When I say DDL, when I ask you what is DDL, of course, if somebody asks you later on, now onwards, what is DDL, you should not say it is for creation of a table, it is for dropping a table. These are all different, you're all right, okay? These are all the commands which will come under DDL, but what exactly is DDL command used for in general? That is what you should first answer. Now, DDL, it is actually a set of commands which are used to deal with the database structure. Okay, when I say DDL, it is a set of commands which is going to deal with the database structure and not the data. It will not deal with the data. It will deal with the whatever command you are going to use in order to deal with the database structure. Now, such a command, you call it as a DDL command or data definition language. For example, we may create a database structure. You may try to modify the structure. You may try to delete the structure. Again, I'm talking only of structure, but not of the data. You are not going to use any of the DDL commands for dealing with data. When I say data, I have a student database. What do we now mean by exactly? Okay, I'll come to this. What do we mean by database structure and data? That also you should know. When I say database structure, suppose I am creating a student database. I'll take a very simple one. Okay, suppose I take a student database. How do I differentiate between the structure of the database and the data of the this database? When I say structure, let us say I have student ID, name, then date of birth, year of joining your college or admission, what course you have taken, which semester you are in. Okay, this is the details that are present in my student database. This outline of my database is what I call it as the structure of the database. Now I'll add something into this, some information or some data into this. Suppose student ID is S1, name is ABC, date of birth is some date, year of joining, course is MCA, semester is second. Second student, S2, XYZ, date of birth, course is MBA, first sem. This are nothing but your data of the database. This, if you are trying to deal with this part of the database, then you are not going to use the DDL commands. DDL command is used only to deal with the structure. I want to delete the semester column. I don't want this column. That means I'm dealing with the structure. I want to make some changes to this course field or the course column. That is nothing but dealing with the structure. Okay, so that is a difference. First, you understand the difference between what do we mean by a database structure and what do we mean by data. So when I say DDL, it is a set of SQL commands which are used to deal with the database structure, but not the data. Okay, so I want to create something, I want to modify the structure, I want to delete the structure. Everything is with respect to the structure. We are not touching the data at all. All right, that is about DDL. So let us see what are the commands that will come under DDL. Okay. Now, so we know why DDL is used. Now let us look at what are the possible commands that will come under DDL. First important command that will come under DDL is create. So this is going to create some objects. It could be a table, it could be a view, it could be okay, we'll go ahead and then see what other possible objects can be created. So any object that you want to create in the database, you make use of this create statement. So you are dealing with the structure. So that is why it comes under DDL. The second important command is alter. So why do we use alter? Alter is basically to alter the structure. As I told you, I don't want that column called as semester. I don't want that in my table. So I want to remove that particular column. So that in that case, I make use of alter. So alter is another important command, which is a DDL command. Okay, next. we have another command called as drop. Drop deletes the objects. Again, it deals with the structure. I will drop the table itself, or I will drop the delete the table itself, not the data. So I'm dealing with the structure. So it comes under DDL command. You should be very, very clear as to what are the commands that come under DDL, what commands come under DML, and so on. Okay. Next. Another important command is truncate. Okay, what is the difference between drop and truncate? We'll look into it when we take up an example there in SQL. Okay, right now I'm not. And then we have grant. Grant is one command wherein you make use of this command if you want to give access privileges to the database users. Okay, some all of us as a user will not have all the privileges. Admin will have the maximum privileges. As a client, we may have some, as an end user, we may have a couple of them. We may not have rights to modify certain database, all that, no? That is nothing but your grant, granting privileges. So when you are granting, you should also be able to revoke. So revoke means you withdraw the access. You have granted some access, you can also withdraw. So these are all the commands which will come under the, these are all the commands which will deal with the structure of the database, and hence we classify them under DDL. Any doubts so far? Any doubts so far? Anyone? Any questions? Any queries?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Things are clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Because these are all very important concept basics that you should be very, very strong before you go into SQL. SQL query, anybody can write, let us say. But still, to understand these basics is very, very important. That's why I'm stressing so much on this even before getting into the lab exercise. All right. Okay. There are no queries.
Ma'am, can you explain again the command?
Which command, ma'am?
Sixth one, ma'am.
Sorry?
Revoke.
Okay. So revoke is nothing but, see, I said we are able to grant. What is grant? Grant is nothing but you are able to give some privileges to the user. For example, I as a user may have the rights to view the database file. That's all. I may not be having rights to modify. Somebody may be given modify option also. But as an admin, database admin, he will have privilege to do everything possible with that database. But we as an end user or a client, we may have only limited privileges. So somebody is granting privileges. Who can do what? For example, one particular student is given what are the privileges that a particular student A can do. A can read, A can view, A can modify, A can delete also. But a student B can only view. He cannot modify, he cannot delete. These are all the different levels of privileges that are given. How do you give? You make use of the grant. Now, once you give this grant, privileges are granted. Privileges need not be permanent. Okay, there can be some changes. So tomorrow, for only for today, I give you some privilege to do this. Tomorrow, I may not give. Tomorrow, I will, what I will do? Tomorrow, I will revoke it. Revoke means what? I will take back whatever privileges I have given to you. That is why I said it is withdraw. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Any more queries or shall we move forward? See, if you are having doubts, please stop me then and there. Ask me. Don't hesitate to ask your questions. Don't.
Ma'am, we have reason. Command.
Sorry, ma'am. Sorry.
We have rename command.
I will come to all these commands later. Don't get mixed up. Okay, rename is different. These commands are different. Well, I'm only telling you what are the commands, a list, a small possibilities of commands. I'm not taking every command into consideration here. As we go further, you should be able to decide whether rename command is comes under DDL or DML. You will be able to tell that. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's proceed further. So that's a brief explanation for DDL commands. Next, we will move on to DML. As we all know, data manipulation language. Okay. Now, why this DML is used? Okay. Now, again, DML is a set of commands. This will allow you to do the changes for the data within the database. Okay. For DDL, what did I tell? I said it deals with the structure. For DML, DML is a set of commands which is going to deal with the data that is there in the database. For example, see, if you look into this screen, I said we have entered two students' data, S1 and S2. Now, I want to change the name of that particular student, or I want to change the semester of that student. I want to change the course. Both are MCA. So I want to change the course of S2, which is not MBA. That means I have to meddle with the data that is there in the database. If I have to deal with the data that is there in the database, then I will go for what is called as this DML or data manipulation. Name itself says that you want to manipulate the data. That's all. You cannot deal with the structure of the database using a DML command. DML command is used only for manipulating or managing or meddling with the data. You want to insert more data, you want to delete some data, you want to update some data, you want to make some changes to the data, you want to leave some column blank, you want to add some data into that column. All this is possible using the DML commands. Or the DML is a set of commands. Again, as we saw under DDL, under DML, again, we'll be learning a couple of commands. So what are the commands that are going to deal with the data? The first one and the most important one is your insert. Insert command is used for inserting the data into the table. All right. So that is why we call it as, why you put it under DML, because you are dealing with the data. You are inserting the data. Structure is already there. You have already created the structure using the DDL command. Let us say create table. You already created it. Now for that table, you have to put in some data now. So when I want to put some data, I make use of the insert command. Insert for inserting some data. Next DML command is update. So I already have some, as I told you in the previous example, I have two students, S1 and S2. One has done MCA and one is MBA. So by mistake, let us say I have written MBA. Now I want to change that MBA to MCA. So I update that particular data. So again, that is used for dealing with the data, not with the structure. Suppose you say I want to delete one entire column. You cannot delete. Using DML command, you cannot delete. You have to again go back to a DDL command. Next is delete. Remember, in case of DDL, I said we have drop, we have truncate, but delete we have under DML. So don't get confused between all the three. All the three are different. So what are the differences between all the three commands? I will tell you once we get into the practical aspects. Okay. So delete is used for what? It will delete all the records. Or based on whatever condition you are specifying, it is going to delete those records. Again, records means it is going to delete the data, not the structure. All right. So anything that deals with the data is a DML command. Anything that deals with the structure of the database is a DDL command. All right. There are several other commands. As we go further, we will be learning it. I'm only giving you some examples of what we mean by DDL, what we mean by DML. Any questions so far? Any doubts? Anyone?
No, ma'am.
Good. Okay. No doubts. Let's proceed. Next is DCL, Data Control Language. Here, we can have some control over whatever data we have entered. Suppose I want to save. Every time I make some changes into the database, I want to keep saving it. I don't want to lose it. Okay? Then such commands will come under DCL. The first and the most important command is commit. Commit. What does this do? It will save the work done. Save the work done. So every time I insert, let's say I have inserted a few rows, I want to save those data. Okay, so I'll have to keep writing this command called as commit. Commit means it will keep saving whatever you have done. The next command that will come under this is called as save point. So save point means it will identify a point in a transaction and save up to that. Okay. When we talk of transaction in the last module, I will be stressing more on what exactly is save point. Till then, we may not be using this. We'll use commit from our very first exercise. Next one is what we call it as rollback. Rollback means, now let us say I have put this commit statement, I have saved it. Now after that, I have done several transactions, let us say. I want to undo all that. Till the last commit, whatever I have done, I want to undo. So then I will make use of this rollback. Restore the database to the previous position. Rollback means basically, you undo, is it? You undo up to a certain point, I am going to undo whatever transactions I have done, I will undo. These are called as data control language or DCL commands. Commit is very, very important. You have to save the work. You keep saving it frequently, that is commit. Save point and rollback. Okay. Next is the last one is DQL command or the data query language. One important command under this, all of you would have learned, is select. So why do we use the select command? It is basically to, if you want to retrieve the data, it retrieves the data from the database. So I have my student database. I have put in all the data about all of you in that database. I want to retrieve now. So I want to know how many of them are having date of birth in the month of May. How do I retrieve it? I make use of this select statement. Select statement is a data DQL command, data query language, because you are able to write some queries and retrieve those values by using this select. Is that clear so far? Any doubts? So these are the four important commands that we have in case of SQL. DDL commands, DML commands. Most important, you should and must know the difference between DDL and DML. What are the commands that come under DDL? What are the commands that come under DML? As we go on doing practically, you will also get more clear understanding of which command is under DDL and which command is under DML. DCL and DQL, these are also very important commands. All right, so it is 10:30 now. We can take a break of 20 minutes, right? We'll come back at 10:50 so that we can. Akrut, I will talk about dropping and deleting that structure as we start with the SQL practicals. Okay, I will talk about that time. I have only touched upon the theoretical aspects now. So we'll have to do it practically and see. 10:50 after the break, let's join in. And that time I will introduce the tool, SQL tool, to you. How does it look after installation? Some of you, those who have installed already, well, no problem on that. But those who have not done it, it's okay. You can still do it by today. But still, I will now introduce you to the tool SQL that we'll be using. So let's come back at 10:15. Okay, thank you. Awesome.